Tonight, the topic I'm going to be talking about, what's the title? Ramadan and Brotherhood, yeah? Very good, excellent. Wallahi, ikhwani and akhawati, my dear brothers and sisters, do you know the brotherhood that Allah gave us as Muslims? There's nothing like it. It's so, so amazing. Subhanallah. I've been away for the last 2 weeks, yes? And what I was enjoying the most was the brotherhood that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with as an ummah. I went back to Canada after being away from Canada for 4 years. For 4 years, I haven't been to Canada. Regularly, I used to go to Canada every year. But I haven't been to Canada for 4 years. And now, this was my first visit after 4 years. And one of the things that I was looking forward to the most was actually seeing my brothers from Toronto. My brothers from Toronto, from Masjid Abu Huraira, and also Masjid Khalid ibn Walid and so forth. So alhamdulillah, when I got there, alhamdulillah, Ustaz Jamal is here as well, alhamdulillah. Oh, mashallah, mashallah. That puts my heart at peace. I can talk a bit more right now, inshallah ta'ala. Since the Sheikh is here, I'm going to be talking a little bit, feeling good about myself. And inshallah ta'ala, I'm just going to warm up the seat for him. So that's all I'm doing right now. So it gives me the opportunity to warm up the seat. And then inshallah ta'ala, when he comes, he'll deliver the, mashallah, the knockout punch. Okay? So mashallah, that's what he's going to do. And so, what was I looking forward to the most when I went back to Canada? The brotherhood. Brotherhood. Subhanallah. Wallahi, there's the brotherhood in Islam, there's nothing like it. So when I got there, alhamdulillah, I met some of the brothers and that I used to know whenever I used to visit, mashallah, Abu Huraira Masjid. And alhamdulillah, that brotherhood was still there. The love and the care the brothers show one another. Even though we haven't seen each other for 4 years and even more, and alhamdulillah, we remembered each other and they have welcomed me so well. Jazakumullahu khairan. And the management, the volunteers, the congregation of the masjid, absolutely amazing, fantastic. Okay? Remember, Abu Huraira Masjid is our brother. That masjid is our big brother masjid. It's a beautiful masjid. And inshallah ta'ala, has anyone ever been to Toronto? You've been to Toronto, mashallah, alhamdulillah. It's nice to have somebody in front of me who has been to Toronto. Anyone else, mashallah? Allah, Allah, our Ustaz, mashallah. Ustaz Bukhari has been to Toronto. Those brothers, how were they when you've been to see them? When you told them that you're from Masjid Alfurqan, they looked after you, you know? Now they're watching. Okay, we have so much love for them, mashallah. Abu Huraira Masjid. Remember your password if you go to Toronto, Masjid Al Furqan. Don't miss that. And let me tell you, I was not this Thursday, like a couple of days ago, the Thursday before, I led the Salah in Masjid Khalid ibn Walid. And then after that, I gave a short kind of like kalima, very kind of like short one. And one of the things I told them was like, subhanAllah, whenever you go and visit Khalid ibn Walid Masjid, or if you go and visit Toronto, one of the things that people will ask you is, are you going to Khalid ibn Walid Masjid? I told them, mashallah, how famous their masjid is, especially among the Somali brothers and sisters around the world. They know Khalid ibn Walid Masjid so well. And I told them, mashallah, Khalid ibn Walid Masjid is a well-known masjid from Toronto. And Sheikh Bashir Shil was there, also Sheikh Abubakar, and other mashaykh from the States as well, mashallah, I've met when I was there. So this is the beauty, you know, when you travel and go to different parts of the world, the beauty of this is like, mashallah, you meet your Muslim brothers, mashallah, and from different parts of the world. And then, alhamdulillah, since the topic that I'm going to be talking about is just about brotherhood in the month of Ramadan, as we are all looking forward to the month of Ramadan right now, one of the greatest things that we are looking forward to is the brotherhood and the gelling, mashallah, and the teamwork and the volunteering that takes place during the month of Ramadan. And brothers helping each other. Brothers, some of the brothers bringing, subhanAllah, the iftar. Other brothers volunteering to help out. And also us praying together, necks side by side for the whole month of Ramadan is an unbelievable event. So this is what Ramadan does for us. That brotherhood, it strengthens the brotherhood among the Muslims. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, during my trip, as I said, one of the amazing things I was looking forward to was the brotherhood. And alhamdulillah, meeting my Muslim brothers in Islam. After I left the city of Toronto, I have been to Qatar. I went to Qatar. This time last week, I was in Qatar. After a 13-hour flight from Toronto to Doha. And one of the amazing things that I've enjoyed most when I went to Qatar was also the concept of brotherhood. Those brothers that I have known before that were in Qatar. And also some new brothers that I've met in Qatar for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As soon as someone finds out that you are someone who's practicing his religion, you are someone who's a Muslim, as soon as somebody finds out, mashallah, while you're traveling, alhamdulillah, that warmth and that brotherhood and that welcoming that they give you is amazing. Subhanallah. That is what you enjoy the most. And alhamdulillah, as I said, I've met brothers that I've known before and also new brothers that I've made right now. New friends, mashallah, new brotherhood. It's unbelievable. So alhamdulillah, this is another beauty. And then after that, I have gone to Medina, the city of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's where I have also met my beautiful brothers from the city of Medina. Shall I tell you the story of what happened to me in Medina? Do you know the brotherhood, subhanAllah? These are practical lessons. There's nothing better than actually having practical lessons than me just giving you a theory, okay? I went to Medina. I've landed in Medina like 11 o'clock in the morning. I knew Medina so well, so I didn't bother anyone to come and pick me up or anything like that. So I took a taxi from the airport. I said to the taxi driver, just take me to the Markaziyah. And Markaziyah is where you find the hotels that are around the Haram of Medina. So when I got there, remember right now, many of the hotels are still closed because of the COVID. Only a few hotels are open. And at that moment, they had many mu'tamirin, many people who came for Umrah. The majority of the hotels are full, but near the Haram. So I went to this hotel. I said to them, do you have any room? They said, we are full. And then I went to another hotel. I said to them, like, do you have a room? They said, we do not have a room at all. Then I went to another hotel. And they said to me, we do not have a room. As I was walking out of the hotel, I heard my name, Muhammed Ali, Muhammed Ali. And I said, where is this voice coming from? An angel that was sent to me. Like, I looked behind me and I found my beautiful brother, Abu Anas. You understand? Abu Anas? Abu Anas from Masjid al-Furqan? No. Abu Anas, brother Abdul Nasir, brother Bashir, who has lived in Medina for 30 years. He graduated from the Islamic University of Medina. Alhamdulillah, he continued to live in Medina. He still lives in Medina. I found him. He said to me, Muhammad Ali, and then look behind, that was Abu Anas. How are you, brother Abu Anas? We had to give each other like the warmest of hugs, subhanAllah. And he said to me, Muhammad Ali, I was just listening as you were speaking to the receptionist and you were asking for a hotel, you were asking for a room. And he told you there was no room here at all, it was full. He said to me, Muhammad Ali, come sit down with me, you will find a room. SubhanAllah. I sat next to him. He had to make some few phone calls. And alhamdulillah, guess what happened? I found a room in the hotel. Brotherhood. I found a room in the hotel. And what happened? What else has happened? Another friend of mine, another brother, who loves me and I love him for the sake of Allah, when he found out I was there, he said to Brother Abu Anas, he said to him, while Brother Muhammad Ali is here, the money is on me. He doesn't have to pay a penny. I'm going to take care of the bill. Practical brotherhood. And he swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, by Allah, he doesn't have to pay one single penny. It's on me. Brotherhood. This is the beauty of brotherhood, subhanAllah. The love that you get and the brotherhood that, subhanAllah, is unbelievable. And on top of that, my also another Muslim brother from the city of Medina, what has happened is the following. Another brother, when he found out I was in Medina, and this brother, he's local from the city of Medina. He's from the Qabila of Juhayna. Have you heard the Qabila of Juhayna? They're the people of Medina. They were there during the time of the Prophet ﷺ and before the time of the Prophet ﷺ. He's a lecturer of the university right now, Sheikh Muhammed ibn Abdullah al-Juhani. When he found out that I was there, I was coming, he said to me, "Ya Muhammad Ali, you're coming to my home. I'm going to do you a what? I'm going to do you a very special dinner." And not only that, he recently got married. He said to me, "You will be the first person to visit my home after I got married." And not only that, he said, "I'm going to invite some of our old friends that used to be from the same class as us, who have just finished their PhDs. Now they became doctors, PhDs, alhamdulillah." He has invited them and they came. And the brotherhood and the love, we were there throughout the night, subhanAllah, the love that people were showing one another, subhanAllah. So this brotherhood, you will not get it anywhere else. Apart from what? From Islam, subhanAllah. This brotherhood. So Ikhwani, do you know your brothers in Islam that you pray next to? The brothers that you come to the masjid with, the brothers that you volunteer with when you're in the masjid. Do you know that brotherhood, the gelling that happens is unbelievable. You need to ask yourself and say, who among my brothers do I love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Just imagine, I was telling to some of the brothers, I was saying to them, if we have missed each other this much, and if we love each other this much, when we see each other, subhanAllah, and we show each other this much respect and love and kindness, how are we going to feel with one another when we go to Jannah? SubhanAllah. Just imagine the day when you're in Jannah and you remember these brothers and used to be brothers in this world. SubhanAllah. How are you going to feel that day? What will you be talking about? What will be the topics and the main topics that you'll be talking about? How many of these days are you going to remember? The days that you were in Masjid Al-Furqan, the days you used to study mashallah together, the days that you used to come to study circles together, you used to listen to the reminders together, the days that you used to be in the masjid together during the month of Ramadan, volunteering mashallah in the masjid. Just imagine all those amazing things. SubhanAllah. So the brotherhood in Islam is unbelievable. And many brothers, subhanAllah, when they meet one another in the masajid, in the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I remember meeting certain brothers during the month of Ramadan in Mecca and Medina, during the i'tikaf. Those brothers, the friendship and the brotherhood that we have developed, there was nothing like it. SubhanAllah. So this is the beauty of Islam. It gives you that opportunity. I know the time is quite short, and inshallah ta'ala, I'll be talking to you maybe for 5 more minutes. And then Ustad Jamal can come and enlighten us with his beautiful reminder, inshallah ta'ala. The next 5 minutes, what I'm going to talk to you about is the following. Alhamdulillah, you have been told for the last couple of days right now, and the last couple of weeks, the importance of getting ready for the month of Ramadan. Right now you should be saying, okay, to yourself, the month of Ramadan is upon me right now. It's coming. I don't even know whether I'm going to reach it or not. Do you know last night? This time last night, I was stuck at an airport. I was stuck at where? Jeddah Airport. Our flight wasn't able to take off. We were told we don't know how long it will take us until we get the permission to leave because of an incident that happened in Jeddah yesterday afternoon. Maybe some of you know about that. Those of you who have been reading the news and everything. Yeah, the fire, the severe fire, the petrol depot of Aramco and what happened to it. We were driving next to that inferno yesterday afternoon. And as we were driving past, I said to the taxi driver, I have a feeling this fire is gonna have an effect on our flight. And that's exactly what happened. Because of the severe smoke that it had created, the dents, and also the clouds, the black clouds over the city. Subhanallah. The visibility became almost zero in certain areas. We plan and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also plans. Subhanallah. I wasn't supposed to be here with you right now. I was supposed to be here earlier. Not only that, after we missed our flight from Doha because of getting delayed in Jeddah, I was told the earliest flight I was able to get was a flight that was going to get me here 9 o'clock in the evening. I was telling the brothers, mashallah, here in the masjid, I'm going to be with you 6 o'clock in the morning, this morning, yeah? But subhanallah, I wasn't here 6 o'clock in the morning. 6 o'clock in the morning this morning, I was still in Doha. I wasn't here, subhanallah. I thought I wasn't going to make it for tonight. Until last minute, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me the opportunity to get a flight, direct flight from Doha to Manchester. After we were told that there was no direct flight from Doha to Manchester. I was told I will be sent to Paris. And then Paris to Manchester after that. And I said to them, there's no way I'm going to go to Paris. I don't want to go to Paris. There's no way I want to go to Paris. I would rather stay in Qatar and wait for the next flight that will be direct to Manchester. But alhamdulillah, here I am. I made it by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I was looking forward to this conference so much. And one of the reasons I was looking forward to it was actually to come and meet you here. And not only that, also to come and meet the mashaykh, our beautiful brothers who came and visited us. And alhamdulillah, I've made it. Now I'm happy that I've seen, mashallah, Ustaz Abu Taymiyyah, Ustaz Abu Muawiyah. And Ustaz Jamal is here as well. And Ustaz Yahya will be coming back tonight. He will be here with us tomorrow morning, inshallah ta'ala. This brotherhood, this love that we have for one another, there's nothing like it. I don't want to talk about anything other than this right now. You might be saying to yourself, why is Ma'alim Muhammad, is he going to tell us any ayah, any hadith yet? No. It's all about being practical, you know, the practical type of brotherhood, mashallah. And the love that you get from your Muslim brothers after you haven't seen them for a long, long time. I met, mashallah, some of my brothers that I used to study with in the Jama'ah Islamiyah. I haven't met some of them, I haven't seen them since the days that I completed the Jama'ah. Like over 12 years, 13 years, I haven't seen them. Now I saw them in the Haram of Mecca. The love that we have shown one another was unbelievable. Subhanallah. They came from different parts of the world. Ikhwani, our brotherhood is irreplaceable. Hold on to your brothers, your Muslim brothers. Keep in touch with them. Do you know the times that we live in right now? People don't like to keep in touch with one another. Everybody's just busy with their phones. Am I right? And their games. No, keep in touch with your Muslim brothers. Do you know, giving them a call, sending them a message sometimes. Sometimes visiting them. Remember the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When a man was walking, and an angel came to him and said to him, where are you going? He said, I'm going to that city and that village. And he said to him, why are you going there? He said, I'm going to visit my Muslim brother. And he said to him, do you have any other reason apart from just visiting him? He said, I have no other reason apart from visiting my Muslim brother. Who can remind me what was the reward for that man? Can someone remember that hadith where the Muslim brother has, where that man has said to the angel, the only reason I'm going to that town is to visit my Muslim brother. Can someone remember that hadith for me? What was the end of the hadith? Anybody who can attempt that hadith? Anyone? Any volunteer? Has anyone ever heard that hadith? Can you remember the hadith? Can someone remember? Let's do a teamwork. Anybody who can remember? Yes, brother. What? Yes, excellent. What? Yes, you know. MashaAllah. Can you see that? Ask yourself this question. When was the last time you visited one of your Muslim brothers for the sake of Allah? Nothing else. You took your car from Manchester, you drove all the way to London just to say salam to your Muslim brother, and you wanted to see him. You know? When was the last time you just went and you drove? The only time that we drive and go somewhere is like, oh, I've been invited to a wedding, so I'm going to see my Muslim brother. How are you doing? No. Have you just made the intention just to go and visit your Muslim brother? That's it, nothing else. So we need to get to that level, inshallah ta'ala. Ustaz Jamal is here, but the great news is, alhamdulillah, mashallah, our Ustaz is here. Alhamdulillah, I'm back and safe here right now, alhamdulillah. And I am looking forward to benefiting from Ustaz Jamal and the other asatidah. And tonight we have the completion of the Quran. Some of our students are completing the Quran. Are you looking forward to that event as well? It's going to be a fantastic event, inshallah ta'ala. I want to also thank our media team. Guess what? When I was traveling around the world, brothers were coming to me and saying to me, are you from Alfurqan? I said, hey, Alfurqan, yeah. You guys are doing a fantastic job. I said, how? Your media team. Muhandis, where are you, Muhandis? MashaAllah. So many different brothers, mashallah, said, you guys are doing well because of the workload, mashallah, and the effort of our media team, mashallah. Jazakumullah khairan. People are recognizing the great work that the media team is doing. So, mashallah, I want to say to our Muhandis Ibrahim, he ran away. You know, he knows that when I'm talking about him, he doesn't like it. He ran away. Okay, inshallah. We're going to get the camera on him, inshallah, ta'ala, next time. And I said to them, like, do you not know that we have the Muhandis? Everybody wants to find out who the Muhandis is now. Subhanallah. So, Jazakumullah khairan. So, I want to say to all of our brothers and sisters here, mashallah, Jazakumullah khairan. And I have a special salam from Masjid Abu Huraira and also from Masjid Khalid ibn Walid, mashallah. They've sent their special salam to all of you guys, mashallah. And mashallah, our brothers from Manchester, from Masjid Al Furqan. So, you've got a special salam from them, inshallah ta'ala. So, I want to say to you, Jazakumullah khairan for coming, and inshallah ta'ala, Jazakumullah khairan for benefiting from this amazing conference. I want to thank, mashallah, the team, the volunteers who have put this together, mashallah, the masjid, our committee, mashallah, of the masjid, and also our dream team, mashallah, the beautiful team that we have, the media team, for putting all of this together, and our asatid and our mashaykh, Jazakumullah khairan for coming. We want to say to them, Jazakumullah khairan for coming and benefiting us. And inshallah ta'ala, finally, or lastly, but not the least, mashallah, we have our beautiful Ustad Jamal, Jazakumullah khairan. Ustad Jamal, when I was in Qatar, we were talking to one another, and he said to me, you need to give a special kiss to the forehead of my sheikh as a salam from me. Who's the sheikh of Ustad Jamal? Who can remember? Who lives in Qatar? Sheikh Abdul Rashid, Sheikh Ali Sufi. I said to him, like, I'm going to visit the Sheikh. He said to me, if you're visiting my Sheikh, you have to give him a very special kiss from me as a salam. And guess what? That's exactly what I did. And I have it on camera. I said to the Sheikh, and the Sheikh, when I went and, do you want me to tell you this? Do you want to know what happened in Qatar? Me visiting the Sheikh Abdul Rashid, his masjid, and talking to him and delivering that special salam from his student. Do you want to know it?
Yeah.
To be continued.